Let's see about the degeneration of conjunctiva. Let's have a quick recap of anatomy of conjunctiva, which we have seen in detail in our previous video, in video of bacterial and chlamydial conjunctivitis. So the conjunctiva is a translucent mucous membrane which lines the posterior surface of the eyelids and the anterior aspect of the eyeball. The anatomy of conjunctiva. Conjunctiva is divided into three parts: palpebral conjunctiva, bulbar conjunctiva, and conjunctival fornix. So the palpebral conjunctiva in turn has three parts: marginal, tarsal, and orbital. Bulbar conjunctiva is made up of scleral and limbal conjunctiva, and the conjunctival fornix has superior, inferior, lateral, and medial parts. So this image shows the bulbar conjunctiva, the palpebral conjunctiva, and the conjunctival fornix, which is in between the bulbar and the palpebral conjunctiva. Coming to the topic proper, the degenerative conditions of the conjunctiva. These include pingicula, pterygium, concretions, and amyloid degeneration. First is pingicula. Pingicula is an extremely common degenerative condition of the conjunctiva. It is characterized by formation of yellowish white patch on the bulbar conjunctiva near the limbus. This is named so because of its resemblance to pinguis, which means fat. So this is a pingicula. There is also an image showing pingicula. Etiology. Pingicula has been considered as an age-related change, occurring more commonly in persons who are exposed to strong sunlight, dust, and wind. Pathology. There is an elastotic degeneration of the collagen fibers present in the substantia propria layer of conjunctiva, coupled with deposition of amorphous hyaline material in the substance of conjunctiva. This is the pathology behind development of pingicula. The clinical features of pingicula. It is bilateral usually, and it is a stationary condition. Presents as yellowish white triangular patch near the limbus. The apex of the triangle is away from the cornea, and it affects the nasal side first and then the temporal side. This is the pingicula, yellowish white triangular patch near the limbus. Apex is away from the cornea and it affects the nasal side first. The complications include inflammation, intraepithelial abscess formation, rarely it can undergo calcification and can lead to pterygium formation. Treatment. In routine, no treatment is required, but when it is inflamed, it is treated with topical steroids. The second condition is the pterygium. This is a picture showing a pterygium. Pterygium is a wing-shaped fold of conjunctiva which is encroaching upon the cornea from the either side within the interpalpebral fissure. Etiology of pterygium is not definitely known, but it is suggested that it is in response to prolonged effects of sunlight, that is UV rays, dry heat, and abundance of dust. Pterygos means little wing, so it is a wing-shaped fold. This is the wing-shaped fold called the pterygium. Pathology. The subconjunctival tissue undergoes elastotic degeneration and it proliferates as a vascularized granulation tissue under the epithelium, which ultimately encroaches the cornea. The corneal epithelium, Bowman's layer, and the superficial stroma are destroyed. Clinical features. Seen in old age, more commonly seen in males, it can be unilateral or bilateral, usually present in the nasal side, and it is asymptomatic in early stages. The symptoms later include foreign body sensation, irritation, and diplopia. Defective vision can occur when it approaches the pupillary area. Signs: the pterygium presents as a triangular fold of conjunctiva encroaching on the cornea on the nasal side. The parts of pterygium. Pterygium has three zones: a cap, head and a body. This area is the cap of the pterygium. This portion is the head and the remaining thing is the body of pterygium. The cap, head, neck and body. Types of pterygium. Pterygium can be either progressive or atrophic. Progressive pterygium is thick and fleshy, whereas atrophic is thin. Progressive pterygium has prominent vascularity, which is less vascular in atrophic pterygium. Progressive gradually increases in size and the atrophic regresses or becomes stationary. Progressive pterygium progresses to central cornea. Atrophic pterygium never disappears. And there is presence of Stalker's line in case of progressive pterygium. Also, we should know the difference between pterygium and pseudopterygium. Pterygium is a degenerative process, whereas pseudopterygium is an inflammatory process. Pterygium is commonly seen in elderly persons. Pseudopterygium can occur at any age. Pterygium is always situated in the palpebral aperture. Pseudopterygium can occur at any site. Pterygium is progressive, regressive or stationary, whereas pseudopterygium is always stationary. In pterygium, the probe test is negative, whereas in pseudopterygium, the probe test is positive. These are the points to differentiate pterygium from the pseudopterygium. So, this picture and this shows a pseudopterygium. In the picture on the right, a probe test is being performed. A probe can be passed beneath the neck of the pseudopterygium. This is probe test positive. The A picture shows the dissection of head from the cornea. B shows the excision of pterygium tissue under the conjunctiva, and the C image shows the conjunctival limbal autograft after excising the pterygium. Next is concretions. Concretions are formed due to accumulation of inspissated mucus and dead epithelial cell debris into the conjunctival depression called the loops of Henle. These are commonly seen in elderly people and in patients with scarring stage of trachoma. The name concretion is a misnomer. They are not calcareous deposits. These are the concretions. Clinical features. The concretions are seen on the palpebral conjunctiva, more commonly on the upper palpebral conjunctiva than the lower. They are yellowish white, hard looking raised areas. Size varies from pinpoint to point head. Being hard, they may produce foreign body sensation. Treatment consists of their removal with the help of a hypodermic needle under topical anesthesia. Amyloid degeneration of conjunctiva. Amyloid degeneration of conjunctiva. Conjunctival amyloid occurs rarely. It is reported in two forms: primary conjunctival amyloid and secondary conjunctival amyloid. Primary conjunctival amyloid is associated with deposition of light chain immunoglobulin by monoclonal B cells and plasma cells. Secondary conjunctival amyloid occurs secondary to systemic diseases or conjunctival inflammation. The clinical features include deposition of yellowish, well-demarcated, irregular amyloid material in the conjunctiva with superior fornix and tarsal conjunctiva more commonly involved. So, there is deposition of yellowish, well-demarcated, irregular amyloid material, and the superior fornix and the tarsal conjunctiva are more commonly involved. This picture shows an amyloid degeneration. Treatment is giving lubricating drops. Excision biopsy can be performed in patients with marked irritation. A quick summary. The degenerative conditions of conjunctiva more commonly include pingicula, pterygium, concretions and amyloid degeneration. This image shows pingicula. This is a pterygium, a wing-shaped fold of conjunctiva. And this image shows concretions. And this is the amyloid deposition. Thank you.